You guys, the D'Amelio sisters just ended Griffin Johnson for good this time. And let's just say that he messed up more than we know. Hey loves, your girl is back again with more piping hot tea for you guys. And just when we thought Bryce was over his ex, Addison Rae, well, we were so wrong. In today's recap, we're gonna be talking about Dixie and Charli D'Amelio exposing Griffin Johnson with actual screenshots of him cheating multiple times. Bryce Hall still being in love with Addison Rae after a new resurfaced video. Mattia and Alejandro getting canceled for making fun of Asian people. There's a lot going on right now, you guys. So let's jump right in. I don't want to sound too dramatic, but there's an entire war going on between Dixie D'Amelio and Griffin Johnson right now, and tons of TikTokers are now getting involved as well. As you guys know, this whole mess began after Griffin decided to make a very shady song towards Dixie, basically claiming that he never cheated on her. However, when Griffin decided to drop the bomb by releasing this, Dixie's sister Charli was not very happy about it and actually responded to Griffin in an interview by saying,
"What do you think about Griffin's diss song to Noah and Dixie?
Didn't he cheat? Wig."
Now, after Charli threw shots at Griffin, the entire situation escalated very quickly after Griffin decided to start tweeting edited pictures of him and Bryce, basically trying to prove how the cheating pictures that got leaked about him were just fake. And y'all, while Griffin was trying to show everyone that he never cheated on Dixie, the tables turned quickly when Dixie had enough of Griffin lying about it and actually decided to hit back with tons of real receipts, showing that Griffin did in fact cheat on her, not only once, but multiple times. Take a look at this.
I was surprised at first, but I mean, I was even impressed with my abilities. I didn't see it coming.
Yeah, guys, she really had enough of Griffin acting like a victim. In fact, tons of TikTokers, including Charli, continued taking sides with Dixie throughout the situation by shading Griffin under Dixie's TikTok video. Yeah, the arched eyebrow pic, please. Dixie receipt queen D'Amelio. This is some real high class ginseng tea.
Real tasty.
So Chase didn't lie. Crazy. No crumbs left behind. Commenting to stay on messy TikTok. At I'm Griffin Johnson. This you? Now guys, if you thought the entire drama would actually end there, well, no. Because, well, Griffin then thought it was a good idea to respond back to Dixie's video yet again by tweeting tons of shady tweets towards her. If a person doesn't make mistakes, are they actually a person? No, they're lying. To err is human. To forgive, divine. The truth will set you free, especially if what's out there is half a story. Hand someone a fish, they eat for a day. Let them into your house to learn to fish, they play with your emotions. I admit to f***ing up, I'm not perfect. God knows I'm not even close, but time for others to admit the same. New leaf, new me. Can't change the past, but can learn to avoid deja vu.
Anywhere.
Griffin? Honey? What are you even talking about? But guys, based on his tweets, it looks like Griffin actually admitted that he did cheat on Dixie. And, for some reason, the Sway Boys, Bryce Hall and Blake Gray, thought it would be a good idea to show love and support to Griffin while the whole TikTok community was going against him. Griff up, Dix clapped back. Move on. All the Hype House members getting involved for clout and acting like they care about this situation should shut the fuck up. Fix your disgusting habits that you hide from the internet instead of just hyping someone up that you use for your thumbnails. Griffin, can I have your attention? Sometimes it's the little things in life that matter. Something as little as a smile can go a long way. I love you, Blake, and appreciate you being a loyal roommate. Do you know a guy? I love you too, Gryffindor. Now stop asking people for toe pics. Anyways, loves, what's your opinion on Griffin getting exposed with multiple receipts? Let me know in the comments. Just when we thought Bryce Hall was finally moving on from Addison with Tessa Brooks, well, I hate to break it to y'all, but we were wrong this whole time. If you have no idea what I'm talking about, well, earlier this week, Bryce Hall surprised the entire internet after he gave us many hints that he could be dating the one and only Tessa Brooks. However, after a couple of days passed without hearing anything from both Bryce and Tessa, many people started believing that they actually could be just friends. And, well, even more proof is now getting posted everywhere on social media after Bryce started showing that he's still in love with Addison. In fact, Bryce ended up responding to a video showing cute moments that Bryce and Addison had together in the past. I'm not crying, you are. We'll still be friends, guys, haha, but wow, we had a mini glow up. Go us. And guys, the minute after he responded with this, tons of people, including Bradison shippers, started freaking out about his response towards the video, with some of them assuming that he could possibly still be in love with Addison. The social media ruined their relationship. I said what I said. Okay, but you can tell Bryce genuinely loved her and she just kept playing with him and his feelings, and that was just messed up. Guess Tessa out of the picture. To be very honest, y'all, I really believe Addison and Bryce might get back together in the future. Mark
my words.
But anyways, loves, what's your opinion on Bryce still being in love with Addison? Do you think social media ruined their entire relationship? Let me know in the comments down below. I'm pretty sure you guys are surprised as to why I'm mentioning Mattia and Alejandro in today's video, but they are back and are now getting canceled for good. If you guys have been around the internet for quite some time, you probably have seen all the scandals Mattia Polibo went through since he became famous. I mean, not gonna lie, he's basically known for being very problematic. However, this time his entire career went downhill after an old video got resurfaced of Mattia saying, "Arrest George Floyd." I really wish this was a joke, y'all.
Arrest George Floyd.
And guys, before the video started spreading across all social media, Mattia took to his spam account on Instagram to address it very quickly by claiming that the video was edited and taken out of context. There's a video going around of me saying arrest George Floyd, and I knew it was gonna come out on people's feeds. Ale was on FaceTime that night while on tour with people, and they were saying f***ed up one of them being arrest George Floyd. I heard it and turned around and repeated those same exact words and then went off about how stupid and racist they sound saying it. But of course, the people in the fandom who hate me the most got a hold of that video. The people who had that video saved took a live photo at the time and screen recorded it, making it a video. It cut off right before what I went off about, and of course it's being spread around. I know what I say and do not say, and I stopped being a childish idiot a long time ago. This isn't what I would say at all. It's people who hate me from the fandom for no reason, setting me up for failure again. But guys, after he addressed the leak video, Mattia felt that it wasn't really good enough. So he instead decided to post a bunch of statements on all of his social media, basically admitting that he has said and done many terrible things in the past, including saying the N-word. Many old things are resurfacing on my name. There was a video I already addressed last night, a screenshot of me body shaming someone back sophomore year, and an old video of me saying the N-word. I apologize for these things that I've said. I admit to saying disgusting things like these in the past because I was an idiotic kid back when these videos were taken. There are times where I said many horrible things when I was younger that weren't recorded. I'm admitting to saying very vulgar, childish things as a joke to make people laugh in school when I was young. I apologize for all the things that have been resurfaced and things that aren't even recorded. I changed, and I know that about myself. People are still out to get me, knowing I'm a changed person. I'm almost 18, and I'm not that dumb to say this again. I love you all. This isn't about anything new. I'm apologizing for all the things I've said in my earlier high school years that haven't been recorded. Instead of acting like I never said stuff like that around that age, I'm admitting to it and saying I don't say stupid shit anymore. There are times that I've said horrible things, including the N-word, that haven't been recorded of me. In my early high school years, I was an idiot, a stupid child who thought saying the N-word and F-slur was funny. I've grown to realize that these hurtful words are nowhere to be said in my position. This is me admitting to saying those awful words in the past. I'm a changed person, and I want you guys to know that. I apologize for the things I've said, even if you've never seen it. I'm admitting to saying them when I was younger. I love you all, and just know I'm a changed person. Now, you guys are probably wondering, maybe Mattia's trying his best to become a better version of himself now that he got exposed. Well, y'all are gonna freak out when I tell you that there's yet another offensive video that just got leaked of Mattia and Alejandro making fun of Asian people. And let's just say, no one was happy about it.
I think no one. I'm Asian
just like you, bruh.
I can't do it.
I can't.
At this point, y'all, people got very upset and angry for always giving Mattia and Alejandro second chances, since they keep messing up and apologizing when they promise to be better. Watch people say,
but he matured.
The bar was already low, but Alejandro, come on.
What?
Race? Hasn't he offended? Now, after this, both Alejandro and Mattia came through with an apology to their fans about the resurfaced video. And the weird part about this, y'all, is that they posted the same apology on their accounts. Y'all really that lazy to write a genuine apology? I'm pretty sure you guys have seen that video going around, and before I go into it, I just want to say I'm truly sorry for what happened in that video. I take full responsibility, not denying anything or making up lies. That video was back in Social Bash, currently 8 months ago. So close to a year now. I am definitely not like that anymore, and I know you guys won't believe me because of what is happening currently, but regardless, I'm changed. I've been educated constantly on many different things and have taken all that in, and it's helped me truly. To put some context on that video, Riley was with us and was explaining to us how she takes Chinese and is fluent with the language, and she told us to try and repeat some words. Not sure if you guys can tell, but we were obviously not in the right state of mind, so we tried to repeat it and bullshit just came out of our mouths. Again, I'm very sorry, but that is the past.
Bye, bitch.
Anyways, loves, what's your opinion on Mattia and Alejandro getting canceled for their leaked videos? Also, what did you think of today's recap? Let me know in the comments down below. I love you so much.